The third unit is material cost, and the syllabus related with you people is in this material cost. You will study material cost accounting and control, means what is material, the meaning of material, types of material, then essential of material cost control, why we have to control the material cost. Then in that we study purchase, what is purchase, what are the functions of purchasing department, steps of purchase procedure, then calculation of EOQ. EOQ means economic order quantity, economic order quantity, storage and its significance, how to store the material and its importance, fixation of different levels of stock. Fixation of different levels of stock means we have to fix the minimum quantity of material to be stored, maximum quantity of material to be stored, average stock to be maintained, and the danger level of stock in your godown. Like that, we have to fix the level of stock in the store. That is called as fixation of levels of stock. Then meaning of bin card. Bin card. Bin card means it is a card kept in the bin. Bin means cupboard. Cupboard means it is a cupboard used to keep the material. Okay. For every cupboard, we keep one card. That card is used for recording the details of material kept in the cupboard. Okay. That is called as bin card. Then stores ledger. Stores ledger means it is the ledger maintained to record the receipt and issue of material to the production department. Then material methods of pricing the material issues. There are so many methods of material issues. Some are cost-based methods. Second is average cost method. Third is notional cost method. There are three methods of pricing the material issues we will study in this chapter. Okay. This chapter is related with material. Material is the one element of cost. Material is the one element of cost out of three. Okay. Whatever we studied already, there are three elements of cost. One is material, second is labor, third is expense. The three elements of cost. Out of the three elements of cost, first element is material. Okay. And this is the important element in the cost structure, total cost structure. Okay. So this is the syllabus related with third unit you have to study in this chapter, in this unit. Okay. Then introduction regarding material. Materials are essential for production of any product. If you want to produce any product, without material, no product. Okay. They are indispensable. They are indispensable from the production process. That means you cannot separate this from the process of production. Okay, for every production there is a material. In simple word, you remember, for every production there is a material. Without material, no production. For production based industries, for production based industries, material are indispensable for every production process. And material cost is the most important element. The material cost is most important element of cost of production because it constitute more than 60% of the total cost. More than 50% of the total cost is of material. Okay. In several undertakings, more than 50% of total cost is related with material. Suppose you fail to manage this. Suppose you fail to manage this cost of material properly, then you will incur heavy loss or your cost will increase at a high rate, because it is the cost which covering more than 50% of the total cost. A small mistake you commit in the management of this material cost, then you have to face so many problems regarding increase in the total cost. It increases the total cost at high rate, then your selling price increases and the customers will not ready to purchase your product because your product is a costly product. Therefore, material is the most important element of cost of production. You have to take care of this material. Suppose you are able to minimize the cost of material by application of by the application of certain costing techniques and management techniques, you can reduce the cost, then automatically you can reduce the total cost of production to the normal level. Okay. Then you can fix the reasonable price for the product. Automatically consumers will purchase your product. This is the basic thing you have to remember. Then according to Indian Association of Material Management, material cost forms 64%. 64% of the total cost is covered by material, 16% is related with labor, and 20% is related with overhead. Overhead means indirect material, indirect labor, indirect expense. Okay, only 20%, whatever you already studied. 64% is the direct material, 16% is the direct labor, and overhead is only 20%. It may be related to factory, it may be related to office and administration, it may be related to selling and distribution. Okay, therefore, you have to give extra care and skill to manage this material cost. As such, the secret of material cost control lies in the saving of material cost. Whatever the secrets you are having in controlling the cost, that lies in saving the material cost. Hence, there should be efficient system for material cost control. You should adopt efficient and effective methods or systems of material cost control. And don't worry. Okay. It is worthwhile to state here that the success of a concern, the success of the concern by and large depends upon the efficient control of material management. I would like to say that the success of the business concern depends largely on the efficiency of the material control, material cost control, because this is the 64% of the total cost. If you control the 64% of the total cost efficiently, automatically the cost will reduce. Therefore, you give additional care and skill to control the material cost. Okay, remember this. Then, what is the meaning of material? The term material refers to all commodities that are consumed in the process of manufacture of a final product. What is material means? Material means all commodities. I don't say this is the material and that is the material. All the commodities that are consumed in the process of manufacture of a final product. Whatever final product you produce is, to manufacture final product, whatever commodities you consume, that is all called as material. Okay. So the material includes first raw material. Raw material means the raw material mainly used for the product. Components. Whatever components you require, whatever tools you require, maintenance material requires, consumer stores requires, all these called as material. All these called as material. It may be jute, it may be cotton, tire, tube, oil, grease, cotton waste, etc. Okay. To get a finished product, to get a finished product from the process of production, whatever commodities you consume or you use, that is called as material. That may be direct material or indirect material. That may be direct or indirect material. Okay. Then the term inventory is also used to mean or denote material. For material, we use the another word, that is inventory. What is inventory? Whatever we put in the process of production, that is called as inventory. Inventory is a broader term. Inventory is a broader term which includes finished goods, partly finished goods, semi-finished goods, work in progress. Inventory is a broad term. It is a broad term. Covers finished goods. It may be a finished product, or it may be partly finished product, or it may be semi-finished product, or it may be work in progress. Also, in addition to raw material, components, spare part, consumable stores, all comes under the inventory. Inventory is a broad term used in the business concern, and material is a narrow term. Material is a narrow term. Then, regarding meaning and definition of material control or inventory control, in simple words, material control. What is material control? Material control is a systematic control over purchasing, storing, and using the material, so as to have the minimum possible cost of material. That is called as material control or inventory control. This is the meaning of material control. What is material control? Material control is nothing but systematic control over the purchasing, storing, and usage of the material, so as to have the minimum possible cost of material. Means whenever you have to purchase the material, you have to purchase the material systematically. Systematical purchase means you have to plan in advance what to purchase, how to purchase, where to purchase, from whom to purchase, how much to purchase. Okay. For what purpose you have to purchase? For all these questions, you have to answer well in advance. That is called a systematic purchase. Once you systematically purchase, that purchased material is to be stored systematically in the warehouse. You have to store it properly. How to store systematically? There should be a storekeeper. The storekeeper is having certain functions. That storekeeper must have certain duties, and there must be a proper place for each and every material. Regarding storing, I'd like to say one sentence. Regarding storing, you remember, there should be place for each material. There should be place for each material, and each material should be in its own place. That is called as storing. There should be place for every material, and every material should be in its own place. In its own place. That is called as storing, systematic storing. And usage. Usage means whatever stored material is there, that is to be used systematically in the process of production. Okay. These three steps are essential for the material control. Okay. First is systematic purchase. Second is systematic storing. Third is systematic usage of material. If you undertake these activities systematically, then it helps to minimize the cost of material. This helps to minimize the cost of material in the business concern. This is the meaning of material control. Okay. Then come to the definition. According to ICMA London, material control is a systematic control over the purchasing, storing, and consumption of material. The same thing. So as to maintain a regular and timely supply of material. So as to maintain a regular and timely supply of material, at the same time avoiding overstocking. This is the definition according to ICMA London. What this is, systematic control over the purchasing, first step. Second step is systematic control over the storing. Then third is systematic control over the consumption of material. Consumption means using that material in the production department. So as to maintain a regular and timely supply. How to control means you have to control in such a way that you have to regularly supply and you have to supply in a time. There should not be interruption in the supply of material. At the same time, avoiding the overstock. Don't make the overstocking. This is the definition according to ICMA London. Then next is, regarding this material control involves systematic organization and control of activities relating to, first is purchasing material. The definition and meaning tells three aspects, three stages. The first stage is purchasing of material. Second is receipt and inspection of material. Third is storing of material. Fourth is issue of material. Fifth is consumption of material. These are the simple steps given for your material control. Okay. First is, what is purchasing of material, how to purchase material systematically. That means you have to make certain plans, policies, and programs related with material purchase. Then once the material purchase, that is to be received properly. That is to be received properly by the receiving department. And inspection of material. While receiving the material, you have to inspect that material, whether that material is according to the given order or not. that is called as inspection. Then once the material is in accordance with the order, you store that material. Once the material is stored, that material is to be issued to the production department systematically by the application of certain store techniques. Then consumption of material, that material is to be consumed by the production department systematically without any wastage. These are the five steps essential in the material cost control. Okay. Then what are the objectives of this material control? The main objectives of the material control is to ensure regular supply of material for continuous production. The main objective of this material control is you have to supply the material to the production department continuously without any break or without any stoppage. Okay, if there is any break or any stoppage in the supply of raw material, then it will create so many problems at different levels. Therefore, continuous supply of material is essential to the production department, because each and every production process is depending on the material. Okay, therefore, the main objective of this material control is to ensure regular supply of material for continuous production. Regularly supply the material. This is the first one. Second is to purchase right material at right price, in right quantity, and at right time. The second objective of material control is to purchase of right material. What is right material? The right material is the material which is most essential to your product, which is most essential for your production purpose. Right material. And that right material is to be purchased at right price. Right price means you have to see all the prices, means all the prices given by the suppliers, which is your feasible price, that is to be selected, that is called as right price. Right material is to be purchased at the right price. Right price means reasonable price. Reasonable price you have to pay. And right quantity, right material is there, right price is there, then what is essential? Right quantity of material you have to purchase. Right quantity of material means how much quantity is required to you people at one order, that is to be purchased, right quantity. At right time means whenever material is required to you people, at the same time that is to be supplied without any delay. Without any delay. Okay. Without any delay, you have to supply the material. Okay. Right material is to be purchased at the right price, you have to purchase at right quantity is essential, and right time you have to purchase. If this activity is undertaken, then there is no trouble in your production process. This is the second objective. And third objective is to avoid excessive investment in material. Without any plan and program, without any systematic techniques, if you purchase the material or if you invest the amount in the material, that investment may be a dead investment. Okay. How much amount you have to invest in the material, the amount is to be invested in the material to the optimum level. Optimum level of amount is to be invested in the material. Suppose if you invest the excessive amount in the material cost, material, then you have to pay additional interest. You have to pay interest on the additional investment. If you pay the additional investment, automatically this increases the cost of production. Therefore, to avoid the excessive investment in the material, we use the material control techniques. material control techniques. Then fourth objective is to minimize the loss due to wastage, deterioration, pilferage, and theft, etc. Suppose if you purchase the material in bulk, at that time there are problems relating to loss due to wastage. Wastage may be possible, deterioration may be possible, theft may take place, fire may take place, or any person may left it. Okay. So avoid the loss due to wastage and other reasons. To minimize the loss due to wastage, other reasons, you have to apply the material control techniques. By the application of material cost control techniques, you can minimize the wastage, you can minimize the deterioration, you can minimize the theft, pilferage, etc. Okay, this is the objective. And fifth objective is to exercise control over the consumption. You can control, you can have, or you can control, you can hold the control over the consumption. Consumption can be controlled if you apply the systematic material control techniques. With the help of systematic material control techniques, you can control the consumption of material also. Means in the production plant, you can reduce the wastage of material. That is possible. This is the fifth objective. And sixth objective is to provide up-to-date information about availability of material promptly to management. With the help of management of this material control, you can give up-to-date information regarding the availability of material and regarding the material requirements to the management. There is no doubt regarding the material aspect. This is the sixth one. And next is significance of material control. Significance of material control. What is the significance of material control? The material flow plays important role in controlling the cost of production. Material control plays an important role in controlling the cost of production because 64% of the total cost of production is in this material. Therefore, the statement, which make the statement that no system of cost control can be considered. No system of cost control can be considered to be complete without proper control over material. Remember this. If you are not having control over the material, then it is not possible to say that we are controlled on the cost. If you are having the control on the material, you can say that we are controlled on the cost. Because this material covers more than 60% of the total cost. Therefore, this is the point you have to remember regarding the significance of material control. Then what are the significance? Importance. The main importance of this material control is it facilitates smooth and continuous production of product. If there is a proper control of the material, automatically there is smooth and continuous production of the product. There is no problem regarding the shortage of material. There is no problem regarding the different quality of material. There is no problem regarding the quality. There is no problem regarding the over and short supply, because there is a systematic control of material. So the first importance is it facilitates smooth and continuous production of product. And second is it avoids excessive investment. The material control helps you to reduce the excessive investment and save the interest. And third is it maximizes the benefit of small and bulk buying by determining EOQ. EOQ is one technique we will study in the coming days. With the help of EOQ, economic order quantity, we come to know the quantity to be ordered at once. We fix the quantity to be ordered at once, which will minimize the cost of ordering and cost of maintaining that stock. That is called as EOQ. Then fourth is, it minimizes the loss occurring due to wastage, deterioration, theft, etc. If there is a control over material, it reduces the loss occurring in future. And next is, it helps the management in decision making by providing up-to-date information. If there is a control over the material, it helps the management to take decisions regarding the material, and you can give proper information to management for decision making purpose. This is the fifth one. And sixth is, it reduces the cost of storage by proper planning. Cost of storage is also reduced by taking steps regarding proper planning of the storage. And next is, it minimizes the cost of production and maximizes the profit of the concern. If the cost of production is minimized or reduced by the application of the costing technique, material cost is reduced automatically, the total cost reduces. When the total cost reduces, then selling price reduces, you can increase the profit. Okay, these are the importance of costing. We will see the remaining in the next class. Necessary steps for efficient and proper control of management, we will see in the next class. Thank you.